One of the big obstacles when creating programmable materials is the problem of assembly. If we want to control a dozen different sections of a material, like these bubbles that move up and down, then we usually have to build a dozen separate actuators and repeat every assembly step a dozen different times. In our research, instead of looking at actuators as distinct modules that have to be linked together, we think about how that might be formed all at once through the stacking of layers. These layers are bulk fabricated through laser cutting, photo etching, 3D printing, and robotic placement. And whether you have one actuator or 100 actuators, the number of layers always stays the same. We introduce an example of this type of material, stoma-board, an array of electrostatic valves that are individually addressable and all feed into a common reservoir. We treat this as a raw base material, and by adding different transducers on top, we can create tactile patterns, soft robotic joints, and pneumatic locomotion mechanisms. The valves are a type of composite mesostructure. They're made up of five layers: a common cavity, a valve sealing electrode, a rubber spacer, a conductive diaphragm, and a valve opening electrode. When we connect the common cavity to a vacuum, the diaphragm is pulled down against the outlet and blocks airflow from above. To open the valve, we apply a voltage between the diaphragm and the top electrode, and an attractive electrostatic force lifts the diaphragm upward, letting air pass through the cell. Combined with an alternating pressure source, we can move air into and out of a transducer layer that sits on top of a raw stoma board. Designing with layers presents different challenges than designing with modules, but the results are scalable and can bring us closer to truly dynamic materials. For the implications of this design paradigm, and more details on the stoma board example, please see our paper.